Hi there! In this part, we are going to learn how to use expansion panel list, and we make a little change such as adding description in our app. We use expansion panel list.radio, which allows for at most one panel in the list to be open. As you see, when I open new panel, previous one is closed automatically. If you are new on my channel, subscribe and don't miss our next Flutter Real App tutorials. So, let's start. Cut this list view builder and paste it here if you need it later. Create expansion panel list.radio, which will have children. And again, here we use task list.map. Add mapper towards expansion panel radio widget, which has the properties of value, header builder, and body. And at the end, we do it to list. Value must be unique, so that the currently selected radio panel can be identified, and we can use task ID for it. Next, header builder, which returns what the first line of this panel will be. It takes a context and a boolean. And we return task style widget. Finally, in the body, we just use text widget for a while until we implement task description. So, save it, and here is our expansion panel list. Next, in the task model, we implement task description. So, just duplicate the title line and change it into description everywhere, like I'm doing. Double check it. And here, in the Add Task screen, we also need to provide with description. So, add description controller. And create its text field. Min lines is 1 by default. Increase it up to 3 in order to make more visible space in the description field. And make max lines 5. Finally, add the description here. We need some padding to separate the two text fields. I do it only top and bottom. And here, when Add Task screen is opened, we cannot see the buttons until we close the keyboard. But there is a way to do it the buttons visible. Just go to Tab screen. And here, add is scroll controlled and make it true. Let's test it. Now, the two buttons are also visible. It's magic, isn't it? Next, let's change the panel body. Instead of just context text widget, we implement task description. The title and description can be copyable and selectable. We inserted boss, title and description here, and we use font weight bold. So we must use selectable text.reach and design it as you want. I designed it like this in the picture. First, use text span widget. And second, in which we implement many child text span widgets. As you see here, all texts are combined. Let's separate them. Just use backslash n. This means the text after it goes to the next line. Ready. But we have some bugs here. Add new task. And expand it. Just wrap the expansion panel with single child scroll view widget. And now it can be scrollable. It seems the error went away, but we have another one. Add some tasks. And when we expand the panel, we'll have overflow because of the body part. Solution is just wrap the all with expanded widget. Let's test it. No errors. And here the body is in the center. To make it in the left side, I just found the solution that is wrapping the selectable text with list style. If you have another solution, please comment it. It may be useful for someone. And one more thing. If we create big title like this, here title will be more than one line. Let's add text overflow in the title. And now we see one line title and three dots at the end of it. Hit the like button and support our efforts. Ta-ta for now. See you in the next part.